Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. We are making a series of videos on technology. Now we are making videos on programming in C. So the first video is Introduction to Programming. Now we are giving an introduction to programming means how to write a program and how we need to become a good programmer, and we are also giving brief introduction about algorithm and flowcharts. So in this topic we are discussing about how to become a good programmer. We are giving what is program and how to become a good programmer. The next is algorithm followed by flowchart. So the definition of a program. A program is a set of instructions that a computer follows in order to perform a particular task. Means, we can also simply say that a program is a set of instructions to solve a problem. Now, we need to know about algorithm. An algorithm is a procedure or a formula for solving a problem. The word derives from the name of the mathematician Muhammad Ibn Musal Kawarimi, who was part of the royal court in Baghdad and who lived from about 1780 to 1815. He also expert in algebra. In the next video we need to know a deeper introduction about algorithm. We need to give the instructions how we need to write an algorithm, and everything should be explained in the next slide. So the next one is definition of an algorithm. An algorithm may be defined as a finite sequence of steps, each of which is precise, unambiguous, and executable in finite time. We are defining in four ways. You can use which one is comfortable to you, you can use it. An algorithm is a well-ordered collection of unambiguous and effectively computable operations that when executed produces a result and halts in a finite amount of time. Third definition, a step-by-step method of solving a problem or making decisions, as in making a diagnosis. The fourth definition, an established mechanical procedure for solving a certain mathematical problem. Now we are going to flowchart. Here also we are defining three definitions. One is, a flowchart is a diagram that uses graphic symbols to depict the nature and the flow of the steps in a process. Another name for this tool is flow diagram. It is also simply we can say that a pictorial representation of an algorithm is also called as a flowchart. A flowchart is a pictorial representation depicting the flow of steps in a program, people in an organization, or pages in a presentation. A flowchart is a visual means to show a sequence of some activities. It shows the sequence depending on conditions. You can write any one of the definition to follow. Now, this is the major part while writing a program. When we are writing a program, we need to follow some steps. Before going to discuss about this, I will ask one question to you, that if you are selected for a software company, let us assume you are selected for a software company and you are undergone 6 months of training on particular technology like Java. You are expert. If you ask any question on Java, you are unbelievable to answer it. If you are explaining the concept, you are ready to implement the concept. That is the status you have right now. Then XYZ is a bank approach to your company to develop automation of a bank. Then the management decided to assign this project to your team. Then first what you have to do? Firstly, you have to understand what is bank. What are the terminologies used in the bank? How the bank is functioning? We need to understand this concept. The second stage, how we need to provide a solution. third step, we need to implement in the reality. And the fourth step, sit with the clients and we need to explain the project, what you did in the past, and any corrections or cross-checking process is done in the fourth stage. Finally, we need to hand over the software to client. Right. These are the steps when writing a program. I am not discussing about big project. I am discussing about only program. When we are discussing about project, we need to know the concept of software engineering development lifecycle. But now we are discussing only a program, a piece of part in a project or a product. Right. So the first part, we need to understand the background details. That is nothing but problem identification. Problem identification means we need to know the background details of the problem. It also gives definitions, statements related to that, and if required, if it is a mathematical, then formulas also noted in the account. And the second part is, after knowing everything about the problem, we need to provide possible solutions, and out of which we need to identify one of the best solution. Here, in the analyzing process, we also make, when it is a structured oriented programming language like C, we need to create flowcharts and algorithms. When it is object oriented programming, we need to create UML, Unified Modeling Language Diagrams are created. So we need to identify one of the best solution in the analysis process. And the next one is coding. Using any one of the programming languages like C, C++, Java, .NET, PHP, Python, Ruby and Rails, Kotlin, D, Haskell, Lisp, using any one of the programming languages, you need to implement. And finally, debugging, we need to compile the program, and if any errors are occurred, we need to rectify it. If no errors are occurred, then it is fine, the best solution for us. And finally, we need to implement, really we need to use it. So the task, when implementing it, we need to follow these steps for developing a program. Now the challenge is, if you want to become a good programmer, how much time we need to spend in each and every step. So in problem identification, we need to spend 25% of the time. In analysis, we need to spend 45% of the time. In coding, we are spending 10% of the time. We need to spend 15% of the time in debugging. We need to spend 5% of time in implementation. But youngsters like you are who are learning programming language are spending more time and money on coding, which is of 10%. But you are not at all bothered about problem identification and analysis. So that is commander almost all 70% of the cluster. So you have to more concentrating on learning problem identification and analysis instead of learning programming languages. Why? Because if you understand one programming language properly, you can understand hundreds of programming languages very easily. But if you are not understanding the concept, if you know the programming language, no use. It is like a type master. If you are good in these two areas, means problem identification and analysis, you will become a team lead or project manager in very short span of time. If not, you are a software engineer or technical supportee in a company. Right, I think you understand. You are spending more time and money on coding, but you are not spending more time on problem identification and analysis. And this next important part is who teaches and how we will get this knowledge of problem identification and analysis. There is no teacher, there is no guru in the world, only one mantra, that is practice. If you practice more, you will get more knowledge. If you are not practice more, you are in dilemma to make it. So one statement we placed here, forget efficiency and start solving easier problems and learn algorithms. And next, when we are taking the problem is converted into machine human instructions using any one of the high level programming languages. After this is compiled to get machine code, and you need to execute the program to get the output. In human before writing human instructions, we need to do analysis. In the next slide, we will give a brief introduction about this. Problem identification is, first we need to prepare an algorithm. After that, we need to generate a flow chart for the algorithm, and we need to cross check the flow is correct or not. If these two parts is completed successfully, 100% successfully, then we go for writing human instructions. That is compiled, and we will generate machine code, and finally you will get output. Thank you.